A lot of brothers have either ras, jumps of the head, or the flat of the head. Is that a, first of all, is it haram? And second of all, if it is not haram, what are the guidelines in regards to that in terms of salah or to drop it?
Now, we've got to ask the question considering that some of our Muslim brothers, Muslims, it's where it is that they still have like ras. Or what is the ruling concerning this in Islam? Firstly, the Messenger of Allah, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, "Man tashabbaha biqawmin fahuwa minhum." Whosoever imitates a people, he is of them. He is of them. Ibn Taymiyyah, rahmahullah ta'ala, mentioned, "Qul al-ahwal," that the reasoning in this is that at meaning in atashabbuh is that it is haram because it can magnify and end up into kufr and disbelief. If it is that, we even start following them in their belief system to lead us into kufr. And the shabbah have common for who are minimum, who's having these people, he's of them. This having dreads, ras, it is affiliated to a religion. Religion, the Rastafarian religion. So this is a worse situation, a worse shabbah. As someone who just mutated someone with a hairstyle, then someone with a particular dress code or something. This has to deal with a religion. And if it is, if he is Muslim, believe, Allah mentioned, Al-Yam Akhmatu Lakum Deen. This day, I perfect it for you. Complete for you your religion. But man to alaykum ni'mati. And also, yes, given us this good favor, he's completed also this good favor of his. Warditu lakum al-Islam deen. And I've chosen for you Islam as your deen, as your religion. So we, if you believe that your religion is complete, then you will know for a fact you don't need to imitate no other religion with nothing. You will know that you don't need to imitate no other religion with nothing. Why? Because what you have, it is complete. What you have is complete, and completion is no perfection. It is perfect. Completion needs no perfection. Meaning it needs nothing to make it perfect. It's already perfect. It's complete. If you have a whole orange, then how are you going to add something to this to make it complete? It's a whole orange. You have a whole orange. What you have to do is peel it and suck it. You can add something to the orange now to make it an orange. You know, it's an orange. It's complete. So anytime you start to add something to it, then you are spoiling it from its original. This has to do something with a religion. You want to look like a Muslim. You want to be identified as a Muslim. When you have this look, first thing someone will call you, "Hey Ras." Let me say it like this now, "Hey Ras." You should feel something in your heart. When you walk the street, someone says, "Hey Ras, watch me now." You must feel like, "Hey Ras, why you call me a Muslim? Why you call me a Ras? Why you call me a Muslim?" But because why? How you identify yourself, the way you look, is the way the people are going to call you. Then if it is, it is impermissible in Islam, for a man to pray with his hair braided. So the message of Allah Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam used to also braid his hair. In time for the salah, he will lose it. For the prayer for the woman, he will lose it. It's mentioned that the shayateen, they take their seats in the nuts in the braid. The nuts in the braid. And imagine this can lose out. Think about the amount of nuts in the grass. Think about how, after laughing, think about how many shayateen that you are toting and carrying, that you're being a seat for while you are in the salah. Think about this. How many shayateen that you will be a seat for while you are in the salah. This should be enough for you to say that's enough is enough. What have many of us, we are attached to certain things. You know, maybe a certain look, maybe a certain scent, so like a certain perfume, maybe a certain dress code. Or maybe definitely, okay, the woman, the love, the way we look also, so you know, we like keep this. But the end result, who are we going to please? The dunya or please Allah or Jalla wa Ala? Or Lord? Are you going to sacrifice our hereafter? Something like this. Like I asked the brothers in my community also, I asked them, you want to sacrifice your Jannah for grass, meaning weed? Every time you smoke your weed, 40 days your prayer is going to be answered for. So you want to sacrifice your Jannah, the paradise, you sacrifice this. For what? For some grass, some dry grass? This is what it is, it's dry grass. You destroy yourself, Islam, for dry grass. You see, we are going to sacrifice our Islam. And disobey the messenger of Allah. Disobey of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam for what? To having here that which is impossible for us to have. Having an attribute, a description of which it's impossible for us to have as an attribute or description. Because why? Because it can be attributed and described to what? To a religion. No, we are Muslims, so we want to be recognized as Muslims. This is what we want to be recognized as Muslims.
That goes with practice. And that goes with practice.
Definitely. In Islam, it's called the practice.
That duties we owe to one another.
Many in the Quran, we see what Allah mentioned was, إِلَى الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا except in those who believe وَعَمِلُوا الصَّالِحَةِ and with righteous action. So look, let's come and believe. I believe that the Christians didn't have this. Did they tell us what? Then believe in the Lord Jesus Christ and you shall be saved. SubhanAllah. Find the amal. Where is the action? Just believe and you shall be saved. Islam is what? Then you have to have the amal of salih. You have to have the righteous action also with the belief. The righteous action is doing what Allah loves and what He is pleased with. So you want to be in a manner, even though we're here to look, the manner at which someone says, you say, yes, Muslim. See, in a creation, we as Muslims, it's not permissible for us to have the hairstyle of that religion, the Rastafarian religion, because it also hampers our salah when we need to pray. We can't lose all the rest when time to pray. We can't lose it. The reason of it is that it is knotted up. It's the reason of it. So you can't lose it out to pray a salah. If you have blood, it's permissible. Then to pray, you have to lose it out. When time to make ghusl. Every time you make the ghusl, every time you have the ghusl of the wife, you have to make ghusl. You have a wet dream, you have to make ghusl. You have a jummah, Allah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Jummah, put it on a kulli Muslim, a muhtalim. He said the ghusl for jummah is bathing. It's compulsory for jummah, it's compulsory for every muhtalim, everyone who even matures. So how are you going to do this properly now? For all the jummah every Friday, every time you have the ghusl with your wife, you have to actually soak this down to the roots. Everything must be properly well soaked. Every time. So you are even placing a difficulty upon yourselves when Allah made this religion easy for us. You can have for yourselves.